10.4, we have to start with question number 4. Let us continue. Question number 4. If two equal chords of a circle intersect within the circle, then prove that line joining the point of intersection to the center makes equal angles with the chords. So the only problem of circle chapter is that the statement is in such a way that in one line everything is given, and that make problem to the student. Anyhow, we'll try to understand this question by using figure, by making figure. Two equal chords of a circle. Yesterday also we did this kind of question, that there is a circle with two equal chords. Two equal chords of a circle intersect within the circle. I'm taking AB and C. Intersecting, suppose at the point. Two equal chords of a circle intersecting within the circle. Jabji, you please do send our attendance to Gurleen ma'am directly. Is it okay? Jabji, are you listening me? Please give some reaction. So, bache, send our attendance to Gurleen ma'am directly. Of your class only. 90 is also there today, but you have to send for your class. So two equal chords AB and CB are intersecting within the center. Let us take chords in the center of the circle. He says prove that the line joining the point of intersection to the center makes equal angles with the chord. Line joining the point of intersection to the center makes equal angles with the chord. That means this is the point of intersection. When I start a line from here and it goes to the center, line joining point of intersection to the center, line joining point of intersection to the center makes equal angles with the chords. That means this line, so first of all you have to see this line is making which angle with these two chords. This line, agar kisi line ka, agar maine is line ka ek dusri line ke saath is line ke saath angle dekhna hai, then these two lines should be joined with each other aise, like l ka m ke saath angle ye. Similarly, this is line whose angle is to be seen, that this line joining the point of intersection to the center, the angle which is which this line is making with this chord AB. This chord AB ke saath line ko angle bana rahi hai OBA. And the angle made by the same line with another chord CD. Ye line OP, it is making at which angle with the chord CD? That is OBC. This angle. So OPA is the angle that this line is making with the chord AB, and OBC is the angle which this line is making with the chord CD. CD ke saath. And we want to prove that these two angles they are equal, and marking them to be equal one angle. Line joining the point of intersection, starting from the point of intersection to the center, is making equal angles with the chord. This we want to prove. That means indirectly we want to prove that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Hame ye prove karna hai, angle 1 and angle 2, they are equal to one another. Dono aapas mein equal. This is what we want to prove, that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. We are given a circle with center chord, two equal chords AB and CD. Yesterday also we did the same question, but the proof was different. We have to prove that the segments of these two chords are equal. This we have proved yesterday. And this time we need to prove that if the chords, equal chords are in such a way so that they are intersecting within the circle, then line joining the point of intersection with the center, which is OP here, it is making equal angles with the chord. That means we want to prove that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. We will write given first. Let us start with the given in group four. Given. Given is a circle with center O and two equal chords AB and CD intersecting within the circle at point P. Intersecting within the circle at point P. To prove OP, that is line joining the point of intersection, line joining the point of intersection of the chords, line joining point of intersection of the chords to the center makes equal angles with the chords, that is to prove angle 1 is equal to angle 2 as shown in the figure. Line joining the point of intersection with the center, that means this line OP, this is making equal angle with the chords, that means we want to prove that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So let us start with the proof. So, you know, whenever we need to prove two parts of a geometrical figure to be equal, the main way is we do it with the help of congruency. But to deal the things with congruency, we should have triangles with us. For that, we have to do the construction. The same construction we'll do as we did in the previous question. Same type of question was there and we did one construction. So before starting proof, I would like to write one step of construction. Draw OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to CD. Draw OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to CD. Draw OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to CD. So after doing this construction, you are getting this part of the figure that I'm taking out. MNOP. This quadrilateral inside, that is going to be the main key point of the proof. So I'm starting with the proof. So a quadrilateral, it is containing our targets, that is angle 1 and angle 2. So we should take the two triangles out of this quadrilateral and we should prove them to be congruent. So I'm taking triangle OMP. In triangle OMP and another triangle ONP. So in triangle OMP and triangle ONP, if we start doing congruency, we need three things for congruency. One is very much obvious from the figure, that OP and OP, they are the common side. OP is equal to OP. This is common side. And this, I'm marking this to be angle 3 and this to be angle 4. And as we draw in construction, we are writing that they are perpendicular. So angle 3 and 4, they will be 90 degree each. So we will write angle 3 is equal to 4, 90 degree each by construction.
by construction. And one more thing that we can write. Can anyone tell me the third part thing that I can use for congruency? Tushar. Yes, Tushar, tell me.
OM equals to OM.
Reason being?
Equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center of the circle.
Very good, very good. OM is equal to OM as AB, chord AB equal to CD. We know that if the chords are equal, if the chord AB and CD, they are equal, then their distance from the centers, they are going to be equal. One theorem we did without any proof, we have to remember this result, that equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. So that's why I'm writing OM is equal to OM. Just to see this part of the solution and see which rule is followed here. One is OP, another is this right angle and this side. So this is RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. Therefore, by RHS rule, triangle OMP is congruent to triangle ONP. Triangle OMP is congruent to triangle ONP. And when the triangle OMP and ONP, they are congruent, then by CPCP, this angle 1 can be equal to angle 2. But let us see that whether they are corresponding or not, because only corresponding parts of congruent triangle are equal. This one is sitting at the point P of the triangle. That means third point we better. And 2 is sitting at the point P of another triangle. That is also 3. That means they are corresponding to each other. So that means we can write, this implies angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by CPCP. And hence, proof. यही हम प्रूव करना चाहते थे दैट लाइन जॉइनिंग द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ द कोर टू द सेंटर मेकिंग इक्वल एंगल विद द कोर लाइन जॉइनिंग द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन टू द सेंटर दैट इज मेकिंग इक्वल एंगल विद द कोर दिस वाज व्हाट वी वांट टू प्रूव वेरी इजी जस्ट यू नो इन द सेकंड क्वेश्चन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द फिगर दैट वाज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट मैटर्स अ लॉट एंड सेम इन दिस क्वेश्चन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द फिगर इट मैटर्स अ लॉट. And in that question also, we have done it by proving the congruency of these two triangles by taking MP is equal to PN and then accordingly applying algebra, right? And in this question also, we are doing the congruency of these two triangles and by CPCT, the result follows. This one is the easiest than that of the previous one because here we are just getting the congruency. We are just doing the congruency and by CPCT, we are reaching the result. That was a little difficult because in that question, we were using the CPCT result and after that we were applying algebra. That's why that seems to be a little difficult to the students. Otherwise, both the question number second and question number third, they are the board paper question. When the paper used to come from board in 9th standard, few years back, these question, they used to come in board paper, second and third board. Chill. Anyhow, let us start with question number 4. Fourth question is, if a line intersects two concentric circles within the circles with center O at A, B, C and D, then prove that AB is equal to CD. But the question is, let us understand it by making the figure. There are two concentric circles. There are two concentric circles with center O. What are the concentric circles? Concentric circles are the circles which are having the same center. Jin circles ka center same hoga, unko hum concentric circles bolenge. There is a line which is meeting these circles at the point A, B, C, D. So let us suppose this line to be L. There is a line L which is meeting the circles at point A, B, C and D. Line L, humne apni taraf se named, we have assumed, otherwise it's not mentioned in the question that this name of this line is L. We are just supposing it to be L. So there is a line L
which is meeting this circle at the point ABCD, and we want to prove that this part AB of the figure is equal to part CD. This is what we want to prove. So let us start with the given. Two concentric circles with the center O, a line L passing through the circles and meeting them at A, B, C, and D. And meeting them at the points A, B, C, D. This is given to us. And what we want to prove? To prove the part AB is equal to CD. Again, the question is based on one step that is called construction. In so many questions of geometry of circle, the thing seems to be difficult to the students only because they are based on one step of construction which students used to forget. So you remember that in every question we are doing some one or another step of construction that is to be kept in mind. Step of construction. Draw OM perpendicular to L. इस लाइन L के perpendicular हमने एक OM जो है वो सेंटर से निकलता हुआ सेंटर O which belongs to the smaller circle and it belongs to the larger circle as well. दोनों circle के center में से जो O है वो pass करता हुआ. So draw OM perpendicular to L. So let us start with the proof. So proof में we are having one smaller circle and another bigger circle. Right. So first of all, see as OM is perpendicular to L. If OM is perpendicular to L, it means OM is perpendicular to each part which is coming on the way to L. That means this OM, it is individually perpendicular to BC. Right. This OM is individually perpendicular to AD as well. So as OM is perpendicular to L, this implies OM is perpendicular to BC. Right? So you can write in smaller circle, OM perpendicular to BC and BC is chord of the circle. Chord of this circle. OM is perpendicular to BC and BC is chord of this circle. You know that the line which is meeting the circle exactly at the two points, at the two end points on the boundary of the circle, that is called the chord of the circle. Isko chord bolna hai to bache isko chord bolte hain. You have to read it as chord. Right, so this is BC is a chord of the circle. So I'm going to apply one theorem. Perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord of the circle always bisect the chord. Perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord of the circle always bisect the chord. That means if this BC is chord of the circle and OM is perpendicular on it, then this OM is going to divide BC into two equal parts. That means BM is equal to MC. So, pehle humne likh diya that this is chord of the circle and this is perpendicular. This implies BM is equal to MC. Mark it to be one and mention the reason. Perpendicular drawn from center to the chord always bisect the chord. So this reason is to be mentioned, and equation number one is formed in this way. Now we'll see that how we'll form the second equation. So you will write also OM is perpendicular to AD. As OM is perpendicular to L, it will be perpendicular to all the segments of the line L. So AD is one of the segment of the line L. So OM is going to perpendicular to AD as well. So OM is perpendicular to AD. And if I rub this smaller circle, so you can see very easily that this AD, this is the chord of the larger circle. Right? So we'll write in larger circle, OM perpendicular to AD and AD is the chord of the circle. OM is perpendicular to AD and AD is the chord of the circle. So using the same theorem that perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord of the circle always bisect the chord, we will write that this perpendicular OM, it is meeting the AD, chord AD at point M. Therefore, AM, this is equals to MD. This is equation number two. Mention the same reason here as we mentioned earlier. So, figure ko dubara bana de zara. This is point B and this is point C. So, we are reaching to equation number one, which is giving us BM is equal to MC, and equation number two, which is giving us AM is equal to MD. Rather, we have to reach to AB equal to CD, what is to be proved. Now, these two equations are in front of you, and you know, whenever with the two equations, we have to form the another equation, only one thing that can help us, that is algebra. We have to apply algebra in these two equations. We have to see according to figure whether these equations are going to be added or subtracted to reach the required target. See, this is BM, this is AM. This is, you see in the figure, BM, and this is the whole AM. And if I want to reach this AB, agar mujhe is AB pe pahunchna hai, so what I should do? From this AM, I should subtract BM. Left hand side ka mil gaya hume, ki hum inko subtract karenge, we'll reach. And on the other side, we need MD. Hume MD chahiye. We need CD. And we are having MD. This is the full MD. And that is MC. This is MC. When out of this MD, MC is deleted, you will get CD. So this figure is guiding us that out of these two equations, to get our proof to be done, we have to subtract. So we'll write 2 minus 1 gives. Bade wala part pehle likho, jisme bada hissa. 2 minus 1 gives. And you know how to subtract the equations. Left hand side will be subtracted from left hand side, and right hand side will be subtracted from right hand side. So we will write AM minus BM, this is equal to MD minus CM. AM minus BM is equal to MD minus CM. And according to figure, when I subtract BM from AM, I will reach to AB. And when I subtract CM from MD, I will reach to CD. And this is what we want to do. So I told you, jitne bhi theorem hum circle chapter ke karte ja rahe hain, you just remember them, because in questions, we are using those theorem as it is in one way or the other. Yahan pe use hua perpendicular drawn from the center to the chord, bisect the chord. And we did it yesterday. I told you that you have to remember this. Proof hum nahi kar rahe because proof deleted hai inke. To aapko kam se kam jo hai, results jo hai, unko learn karna. It's very important this time. Chaliye. Question number fourth is done. Let us start with the next question. Fifth question later on I will teach afterwards. Iske sixth ke baad ya baad mein karwaungi isko. Pehle hum shuru karne ja rahe hain question number sixth. See. Sixth question is,
There is a circular park of radius 20 meter situated in a colony. Circular park. Center O. Radius 20 meters hame given hai. Three boys, Ankur, Sayyad and David are sitting at equal distance on its boundary. On the boundary of this park, three boys, I'm marking them to be Ankur A, Sayyad S and David D. They are sitting on the boundary of the circle in such a way such that distance between them remains the same. Ek jaise distance chhod ke wo tino boundary pe baithe hue hain. Each having a toy telephone in his hand to talk to each other. They are having toy telephone in their hand and they are talking to each other. आपने देखा होगा बच्चों को वो ग्लास के साथ डिस्पोजेबल ग्लासेस के साथ टॉय टेलीफोन बना के बीच में तार से अटैच करके दे यूज टू प्ले गेम लाइक दिस सो दे आर टॉकिंग टू ईच अदर ऑन द टॉय टेलीफोन वैसे तो आपको लोगों के पास आजकल फिर से दोबारा फोन हमारे हाथ में आ गया कोरोना आया फिर से फोन मिल गया हमें है ना तो टॉय टेलीफोन की तो बात ही छोड़ दो फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग ऑफ ईच फोन अंकुर के हैंड में फोन का एक पार्ट है One part is in the hand of Sayyad and similarly one part is in the hand of David and there is a string between the two parts of the phone. So this is the length of string between Ankur and Sayyad. This is the length of string between Sayyad and David and this is the length of string between Ankur and David. As they are sitting at equal distance from each other, that means these length of the string, whether you are calculating from A to S or you are getting calculating from S to D or you are calculating from D to A, they will remain the same. Same hoegi length of the string. Kyunki wo equal distance pe baithe hue hain. They are sitting at equal distance from one another. So string length will remain the same. We want to find this string length. Now see. This side, and this side, these all sides, they are coming out to be equal. This seems to be a triangle. It is forming a triangle, AST. So the difference, the length of the sides of the triangle, three sides, they are equal. They seem to be equal according to the question. That means it is going to be an equilateral triangle. This is very much clear that AST, this will be an equilateral triangle. And we want to find the length of string in every equation, whether we are doing algebra, whether we are doing, you can say, a word problem of ratio proportion, whatever is to be find, that is to be supposed. So we want to find the length of the string. We'll suppose the length of the string. Most of the time, we suppose whenever we are letting the things, we suppose it to be X. But this time I'm taking it to be 2X and I will tell you the reason why I'm taking it to be 2X instead of X. Suppose. Let length of the string be 2x. अब इसके पीछे एक रीजन है कि मैं ये जो स्ट्रिंग की लेंथ है उसको 2x ले रही हूं बिकॉज मेरे को जब परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करना है ना ये इस क्वेश्चन को डील करने के लिए मुझे वर्टेक्स ऑफ द ट्रायंगल से और सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल से पास करता हुआ ओपोजिट साइड पे एक परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करना है दिस इज अ वे टू फाइंड एक्स इन दिस क्वेश्चन ठीक है सो आई एम राइटिंग ड्रॉ एम परपेंडिकुलर टू एस टी passing through the center of the circle. Passing through the center of the circle. Draw AM perpendicular to ST passing through the center of the circle. Right now, In triangle ASD, AS is equal to ST is equal to AD is equal to 2X. This implies
ट्राइंगल ए एस डी इज एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल, मेंशन कर दो यहाँ पे इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल,
ए एस डी इज एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल. And you know, whenever one perpendicular from the vertex to the opposite side of an equilateral triangle is drawn, that perpendicular always bisect the opposite side.
So, therefore, AM will bisect AD, ST. This happens in the case of equilateral and isosceles triangle. The perpendicular drawn from the vertex to the opposite side always bisects the side on which it falls. It is falling on ST. That means it is going to bisect ST. That's why, now you can realize, that's why I'm taking it to be 2x. So that after bisecting, when I have to do half, instead of dealing with fractions, that means had it been x, its half will be x by 2. And we have to do the calculations in the fractions. To avoid that calculation, it's a fractional calculation, I'm taking it to be 2x so that it's a half become x. This implies SM, ye wala, it is equal to half of ST, bisect kar rahe ST ko to. So SM is equal to half of 2x, so this is equal to x. Ab aapke mind mein ye aayega ki is SM ke magar hum kyun padhenge, iske piche hum kyun padhenge.
Abhi pata chalega why. So
ठीक है, अब हमें x निकालना है. x के लिए वी नीड सम इक्वेशन एंड फॉर दैट वी आर मूविंग फ्रॉम हेयर टू देयर एंड देयर टू हेयर. नाउ ज्वाइन ओ एस, ज्वाइन ओ एस. नाउ यू नो दैट इन दिस होल क्वेश्चन x जो है उसको फाइंड करना हमारा टारगेट है. तो अगर मैं दिस पार्ट ऑफ द फिगर इफ आई सी, दिस पार्ट ऑफ द फिगर इफ आई सी, this is a right angle triangle. According to our construction, this is a right angle triangle. Chalo, we'll continue tomorrow. This question will continue tomorrow. Well has gone. Yahan tak acche se is par isko padh lenge.